Hello students, today we are going to discuss about third cranial nerve.
The third cranial nerve or the oculomotor nerve, it is the largest of the ocular motor nerves. It contains 15,000 axons that includes motor fibers and parasympathetic motor fibers. The nerve entirely motor in function. It supplies levator palpebrae superioris muscle and all extraocular muscles except lateral rectus and superior oblique muscle. Next, we are going to discuss about the functional components of oculomotor nerve, which is divides into three: the somatic efferent component, general visceral efferent component, and general somatic efferent component. The somatic efferent component is concerned with the movement of the eyeball, the motor supply to the muscles, which is derived from head myotomes, that is levator palpebrae superioris, superior rectus, medial rectus, inferior rectus, and inferior oblique muscles. The general visceral efferent or the parasympathetic component of the nerve, it is meant for accommodation and contraction of the pupil, the motor supply to ciliaris and sphincter pupillae muscles. The general somatic afferent component of the nerve, it is associated with proprioceptive impulse from the extraocular muscles that supplied by somatic efferent component of this nerve. Next, we are discussing about the nuclear complex of third cranial nerve. The nucleus of the third cranial nerve is located in the midbrain at the level of superior colliculus in the ventromedial part of the central gray matter that surrounds the cerebral aqueduct. The fibers for the constrictor pupillae and for the ciliaris arises from the Edinger Westphal nucleus, which forms part of the oculomotor nuclear complex. We are discussing relations on dorsomedially, which is related with the central gray zone, which is surrounded by cerebral aqueduct, the ventrolaterally, the medial longitudinal bundles, and superiorly, which approaches the floor of the third ventricle, inferiorly, which is continuous with the trochlear nucleus. Nucleus of the third cranial nerve, it is located in the inferior periaqueductal gray matter of the mesencephalon. It is a complex of both paired and midline motor cells. These cells are found from the posterior commissure superiorly to the pontomesencephalic junction caudally in the dorsal midbrain. Next, we are discussing about course and distribution of third cranial nerve. Its course is divided into four parts: the fascicular, basilar, intracavernous, and intraorbital part. The fascicular part consists of efferent fibers which passes from the third nerve nucleus through the red nucleus of the medial aspect of the cerebral peduncle. They emerges from the midbrain and passes into the interpeduncular space. Second, the basilar part, which starts as a series of 15 to 20 rootlets in the interpeduncular fossa. They are called say to form a large medial and a small lateral root, which unite to form a flattened nerve. Then it twisted and bringing the inferior fibers superiorly and the superior fiber inferiorly, and thus the nerve become a rounded cord. The nerve then passes between the posterior cerebral artery and the superior cerebellar artery, and that run forward in the interpeduncular cistern to reach the cavernous sinus. Next, the intracavernous part. The nerve enters the cavernous sinus by piercing the posterior part of roof of the lateral side of the posterior clinoid process. It then descends to the lateral wall of the sinus, where it is lies above the trochlear nerve. In the anterior part of the cavernous sinus, the nerve divides into superior and inferior division, which enters the orbital through the middle part of the superior orbital fissure within the annulus of syn. In the fissure, the nasociliary nerve lies between the two divisions, while the abducens nerve lies infralateral to them, the intraorbital part. In the orbit, the smaller superior division that ascends on the lateral side of optic nerve and supplies the superior rectus and the levator palpebrae superioris muscle. The longer inferior division divides into three branches. First one, nerve to the medial rectus that passes inferior to the optic nerve. Second, nerve to inferior rectus that passes downwards and enter the muscles on the upper aspect. Third one, nerve to inferior oblique that passes in between the inferior rectus and lateral rectus and supplies the inferior oblique from its posterior border. It gives off the motor root to the ciliary ganglion. Then we can discuss about some clinical importance of third cranial nerve. The first condition, it is called as partial ptosis or the dropping of upper eyelid due to the paralysis of voluntary part of levator palpebrae superioris muscle. The second condition is called as a lateral squint. This condition in which the eye do not align properly. The third condition is called as a dilatation of the pupil due to the paralysis of the parasympathetic fibers to sphincter papillae muscle. The fourth condition is called as loss of accommodation due to the paralysis of ciliary muscles. This is all about the third cranial nerve. Thank you.